In this video, we are going to look at reproduction in plants and reproduction in humans. So, let's begin. Okay, let's start with the four processes that we learn in reproduction in plants: pollination, fertilization, seed dispersal, and germination. Let's take a look at pollination first. So for pollination, what are the things that you will need to know? You have to know the parts of the flowers, okay, the parts that are contributing to the reproduction in flowering plants. Also, how the pollination can occur in flowering plants, like by pollinators or by wind, and the different types. Say, for example, the characteristics, by pollinators, they are bright and colorful, and sweet scent, sticky stigma. Okay, whereas by wind, you will have dangling stigma and dull color. Okay, next, let's look at fertilization. It is the fusing of the male reproductive cells and the female reproductive cell. So when that happens, okay, the flower will turn into a fruit. So the petals will drop off and it will grow into a fruit. And inside the fruit, the ovary grows into a fruit, okay, and then the ovule will become the seeds, and when the fruit is ripe, the seeds will be dispersed, because that is how the plants want to reproduce. Okay, they need the seeds to go elsewhere and new plants can grow. So what are the ways of seed dispersal? We have learned of four ways. Okay, so first by animal, then also by water, by wind, and by splitting. By animals, there are three ways, and the three ways are: where the fruits are freshy, they will throw away the seeds after eating, or they pass it out in a dropping, and also hooks on the seeds to hook onto a fur. By water, it will be fibrous husk where it can float on water, waterproof covering. By wind, there may be wing-like structure, light, okay, and splitting, when it's ripe, it will split open and the seeds will just burst out. Right, so let's take a look at germination now. Let's see what are the needs for a seed to germinate. They need air, water, and warmth, but they do not need sunlight at this point of time. Why? Okay, let's take a look at the seed first. What came out first will be the roots. After the roots come out of the seed, you will have the shoots coming out. Okay, so when the shoots come out, only after the first leaves grow, they need sunlight to make food and grow. Right, so I want to show you how, if you look at your beansprout grow, okay, you will see that there's this part that come up with it. Okay, that are the parts of the seed that come out with it, and then they will drop off. Those are the seed leaves. Those are giving the plant the food, okay, before the first leaf come out. Then after the first leaf came out, they can take in the sunlight, make food, photosynthesis will be occurring, and the seed leaves will drop off. Okay, they don't need the food from the seed leaves anymore from there. So after germination, what happened? The seed grow into a young plant. Okay, and the young plant grow into the adult plant. So that is the plant life cycle. And from there, the adult plant will bear flowers. Okay, so the flowers will continue with this cycle of reproduction in flowering plants, where all the things you learn about parts of flowers, pollination, will continue to occur. That's why I draw it as a cycle. So you need to know about the whole cycle that ensure that plants continue to reproduce. So next, the parts of the flowers that you really need to know, because this is the first part of this chapter. You need to know what are the parts, which are the male parts, which are the female parts, and also what is the function of each part of the flowering plant. Okay, that contributes to the reproduction in plant. So you need to know that there's the stigma, okay, that receives the pollen grain, the style holding the stigma, the ovary and the ovule. Okay, ovule has the egg cell. Then there's the anther that produces the pollen grains that contains the male reproductive cell and the filament holding the anther. Right, so from here, what we learn about fertilization, fusing of male reproductive cell and female reproductive cell, that ensure that this flower can grow into a fruit. But what about reproduction in humans? Okay, so you know the chapter that follows reproduction in plants is reproduction in humans. So in reproduction in humans, okay, you learn about the different parts of the male reproductive system and the female reproductive system in humans. So we need to know the parts and the functions just like when in reproduction in plants. Now I'm going to show you a comparison between the reproduction in plants and reproduction in humans, especially comparing the male parts and the female parts. So let's begin now. From here onwards, I will just let you watch the video. Okay, I will make some annotations to make it quite self-explanatory. So enjoy the video. Have a good revision for science.